So I know that you've done a lot of great work in the 3 years that you've been here around diversity and inclusion. Could you please just break it down from like a step-by-step basis on how you did it?
Sure. I mean, I think the first thing is I do believe in establishing a baseline and understanding where you stand. So
yeah.
Being able to measure it and demonstrate improvement over time, I think it's valuable. So that's one. I think the other thing is involving your employee base. No one wants anything done to them.
That's a good point.
So getting people engaged, we have a culture ambassador program that was started actually before I got here. It was a D&I ambassador program. We turned it into a culture ambassador. And those individuals are representatives from various parts of our organization, each department, each function, each location.
Mm-hmm.
And then they help shape the agenda and the strategy. They help shape content for our video series, our current event dialogues, all of those kinds of things. It's the employees that are actually experiencing our
culture. Gives them some ownership.
They're a big part of it. So that's a huge element of our success. And then I also think top down, you've got to have senior leadership support of those kinds of things and really make sure that when it comes down to behaviors that you might see in the workplace that go against an inclusive culture, that you've got leaders that are willing to put themselves behind that and drive accountability.
Yep.
And we have that.
Yep.